This week in Jamaica Now.
Where you never have a parish, mind you, RADA, you know a laborer being the chairman of RADA.
Ruddy's regret, the state minister's controversial comments about RADA benefits for labor rights. The prime minister rejects the comment. Jamaican flight attendant held in New York in cocaine bust. State of emergency declared for St. Catherine North Police Division. Major General Anthony Anderson takes charge of the JCF as police commissioner. Teachers and nurses accept retro payment this month, but no sign yet when their wage negotiations will conclude. And the spectacle of CHAMS 2018. I'm Damian Mitchell, and this is Jamaica Now. Prime Minister Andrew Holness is to hold talks with the State Minister of Finance, Ruddy Spencer, following controversial comments made by the Clarendon Southeast MP at a Jamaica Labour Party meeting in Belfield, Manchester on Sunday. Mr. Spencer has promised increased benefits for labour rights through the Rural Agricultural Development Authority now that a JLP member is the chairman.
Where you never have a parish, mind you, RADA, you know a labour right being the chairman of RADA. So whatever problems you used to have, no, I want him here. Whatever problems you used to have, I believe now most of the problems or those problems would have gone away because you have your own manager to assist in the management of RADA. So therefore, you can't say that you are getting no attention. You can't say nothing is happening. Because in fairness, you have your own manager to report whatever problems you have and expect him to solve those problems.
The People's National Party's caretaker for Clarendon Southeast, Patricia Duncan Sutherland, has expressed concern over what she calls a pervasive and flagrant use of state resources for partisan political gain and made a call for Spencer to resign. However, Spencer said there is no reason to resign, maintaining that he was merely seeking to assure people that there would be an end to political bias at RADA. A crew member of a Fly Jamaica Airways flight is now in custody in New York after he was caught allegedly trying to smuggle cocaine into the U.S. Jamaican Hugh Hall was held by U.S. Border Patrol agents at the John F. Kennedy International Airport on Saturday, allegedly with four packages taped to his legs, each containing cocaine valued at $160,000 or just over 20 million Jamaican. Hall was part of the crew of a Fly Jamaica Airways flight that arrived from the Sangster International Airport in St. James. Border agents reportedly ordered him into a private search room where they allegedly found cocaine with a total weight of 9 pounds. Hall was ordered held without bail when he appeared in a Brooklyn federal court on federal drug smuggling charges on Monday. Manchester Central MP Peter Bunting is questioning the legitimacy of an investigation by the Firearm Licensing Authority surrounding allegations of a gun-making machine in Manchester. FLA CEO Shane Dalling says a high-level probe is underway into several persons in the parish who had requested permits for more than 100,000 rounds of ammunition. However, Bunting is skeptical of the move. The Manchester businessman whose property was the subject of investigations through his attorney, John Juna, says at least 8 other such machines were legitimately imported to Jamaica and their purpose is not for making guns. The police are reporting that 4 members of the Montego Bay-based G-City gang are among the more than 120 people detained this week in the state of public emergency in the St. Catherine North Police Division. 3 wanted persons were also among a group of more than 60 men picked up by the police in St. Catherine on the same day. Most of the detainees have been processed and released. Assistant Commissioner of Police Derek Knight, who is in charge of the Area 5 Police, said that of the 48 murders recorded in St. Catherine North up to Sunday, 36 were believed to have been stemmed from infighting within the Klansman gang. As a result, he said that the police and military would now be going all out to locate 20 main violence producers in the parish. He said the reported leader of the Klansman gang, Tesha Miller, is also being sought by the police. And there is growing speculation that former head of the JDF, Major General Anthony Anderson, will look to his former colleagues for help as he takes over as Commissioner of Police. Among the first tasks that Anderson will have to tackle is filling 2 vacancies that exist at the top level of the Jamaica Constabulary Force. The new commissioner, who took office without the pomp associated with such installation ceremonies in the past, will have two clear vacancies in the deputy commissioner ranks that he will be able to make recommendations to fill. The JCF has been short two deputy commissioners since Novlet Grant, who was in charge of administration and support services, and Ray Palmer, who was in charge of the Inspectorate of the Constabulary, retired earlier this year. General Anderson says improving morale among cops and the deepening of investigative capacities are among things that will be critical under his leadership. Public school teachers and nurses have now accepted the 5% retroactive payment pending the outcome of their salary negotiations by the Finance Ministry. This is an about turn by public sector workers who just over a week ago rejected the proposal by the government. The government, through State Minister of Finance Ruddy Spencer, had been insisting that they would have to wait until 2020 to get the payment retroactive to 2017 if they did not accept it before March 31. Finance Minister Audley Shaw says accepting the retro payments will not affect the ongoing negotiation with the government. A woman was seriously injured when the Toyota Costa bus in which she was traveling was hit by a truck transporting yams Thursday morning. The crash happened near the Caymanas exit of Highway 2000, renamed the PJ Patterson Highway. The woman was rushed to hospital with serious injuries to one of her legs. An eyewitness said the woman was just about to get off the bus when the accident happened. Meanwhile, some of the persons who converged on the scene sought to help themselves to the produce that was strewn on the highway. It is reported that the yam truck was heading to the Coronation Market in Kingston. And that's it for this edition of Jamaica Now, your weekly review of the big news stories. Send us your comments at onlinefeedback@leanerjm.com. You may tune in to Power 106 FM for regular updates. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Jamaica Leaner and on Facebook at Leaner Jamaica. I'm Damian Mitchell, and before we go, highlights from the 2018 staging of the Boys and Girls Athletics Championships.